live. Thank you. Welcome to Sunday Night Labs. Please, a round of applause for Basket Man. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity. Yeah. Wow. This is not the original career I wanted to do with my life. I'm from Delta State, and we're not born into poverty. We just found ourselves there. How we got there, we don't know. But we got there. And so the easiest way to leave poverty, being from Delta State, is to work in an OFM. My mother filled my jam form. The course she wrote, I was inside crude, petroleum engineering. I didn't get the admission. My mother asked, what else can lead him there? They say mechanical, fill it. That's how I ended up graduating from mechanical engineering. Right now, I'm doing my work here, online. But that's why I say in this country, you can't do one work and survive. You have to find a double stream of income. That's why if you notice, almost every church have a school. If you don't drop offering, you drop school fees. You must drop something. You can't run. You can't run. No, it's the truth. So in this country, policemen at night are Okada men. It's double stream of income. What they don't collect from you at checkpoint, they collect you by taking you home. It's as simple as that. Doctors that have hospital have mortuary. If they treat you, you know where you die. They will still collect the money. But your spirit and flesh, they are... See, me, yes, I graduated from mechanic. You know how many doctors are working in the bank? You go to withdraw money, the guy looks at you, say, madam, it's like a temperature is rising. And you ask him, how did you know? He said, that's my first degree. It's the country that put me here. No jokes. The best graduating student from chemical engineering in my school, as I speak to you, is not a masquerade. Every New Year Fest... You know, as a comedian, we all have dreams, and my dreams brought me to Lagos. I stood that for you to make it as a comedian, you have to come to Lagos. So July 26, 2012, I entered bus, got to Lagos, paid 3,000 naira transport fare, passed 5 states and 7 rivers, 3,000. Got to Jibowu, 6:30 p.m. I told cabman, take me to Ejibu. He said, 3,200. I said, oh, God, wait, I just used 3,000 to pass 5 states. Inside Lagos, he was charging me 3,200. And he asked me a question. He said, when you enter Lagos, did you see welcome to Lagos? I said, no. He said, what did you see? I said, I saw this is Lagos. He said, nah, be this. I took back 1,700 that night. After a while, I told my friend that I need to get my house. I'm tired of squatting. God will judge that boy. Henry, wherever you are, God will judge you. Deceive me. Took me to a corridor around 12 o'clock. The road was free. I said, there's even no traffic on this side of Lagos. I didn't know that the people that caused the traffic have not closed from work. I now saw house, 72,000. I paid parking, wash house. Called my friend that lives in Lagos. I said, my brother, I've gotten a house in Lagos. He said, so quick. I said, it's God. You know, in this country, whatever you cannot explain, you shift it to God. I said, it's God. He said, by the way, where did you get this house? I said, Korodu. He said, my friend, you just went back to the east. I didn't understand until the following morning when I got to a bus, to the bus stop, enter bus, 8 a.m. by 10, we've not moved. I asked the man by myself, I said, God, what kind of traffic is this today? He said, it's not today, it's every day. I said, eh. I said, so where's the alternative route from here? He says, Shagamu. I said, it's not Benin I'm going to, it's all Jota. He said, you have to be patient. I said, oh, God, by the way, before I came to Lagos, I saw videos of Lagos, tall buildings, skyscraper. I've not seen them in this side. You know, I asked, are you new here? I said, yeah, he said, it's obvious. I said, why? He said, Lagos is divided into two parts, island and mainland. I said, what's the difference? He said, island is for rich people, mainland is for the upcoming rich. I said, so where are we? He said, we're on other lands. I said, oh, we're not even close to making it. He said, okay. He said, are you shocked? I said, I'm shocked. He now said, how much is the house rent? I said, 72,000. He said, your mind told you that you're in Lagos? I said, I don't understand. He said, Lagos rent is from 250 upwards. I said, so where are we? He said, Jebu, the extension. I said, Mama, I must go to that island. Only for me to get to Lekki. And found out that 70% of the people on this island are poor people that have faith that they'll make it. They have not made it. Anybody you call in Lagos and I say, I'm coming to your house. And I say, before you come, call me, don't go. You will never reach it. You are traveling. Or just carry backpack. Carry everything. I enter road to see my friend in Lekki. He said, why are you now? I said, I'm a jack on day. He said, keep coming. I said, I'm at Chevron roundabout. He said, maintain straight. I said, I'm at VGC. He said, you're on track. I said, I'm at the second toll gate. He said, it's free. Oh, pass it. I said, I'm at Ajana. He said, you are just starting. Yeah? I got to Lagos business. I said, my brother, I've reached Lagos business. He said, you can't miss it. I said, is this Lekki? He said, what did they write at the signpost? I said, Beju Lekki. He said, that's the father. Be coming. I said, I've reached Awoyaya. He said, follow them. I've reached Bogija. He said, don't miss it. I'm at Ekpen now. He now said, when you get to Jebu, they help me buy banana. No, Akma, you there still. You know, thank you. You know, but Lagos is a unique place. You have to be smart in Lagos. Because Lagos is the only place in the whole world where Google Map will lead you into one way. Yeah, in 800 meters, turn right. You will not follow technology that does not know Lagos and turn right. How I knew I was the wrong way was that after 4 minutes, I was the only person going to that side. And everybody that was coming, and when they passed me, they would shake their head and say, oh. And I saw last man, I said, let me form good citizen. And I went, I said, excuse me, sir, is this one way? He said, my brother, yes, this is where they pay when we catch them. Just come down and pay. Lagos, powerful place. I advise Lagosians, don't buy gadgets in traffic. My friend bought power bank, $450. I said, why is it so cheap? He says, Indian product. They entered the market. When he plugged it, it was his phone that was charging the power bank. The one that happened to me, I bought sardine, four together, 100 naira. My friends, my neighbor said, why is it so cheap? I said, it's God. We now open sardine with this fish. We saw fuck mama soft ones and red oil inside. I said, my brother, we didn't lose. Oh yeah, cook stew with it. I cannot keep myself. You know, but as I got to Lagos, it was obvious I was from Enugu. Because if you see the white dress, big trouser, big shirt, I said, no, I want to dress like Lagosians. They said, okay, since you live in Ikorodu, go to my 12 under bridge from 7 p.m. is a mall. It's no longer a bridge. They sell anything. You can even buy land. You can pay bride price. Anything you can do there. And I saw one guy, mobile shop, arrange clothes on the floor. 7 p.m. I said, how much for this package shirt? He said, 700. He said, can I test it? He said, 1.5. I said, why? He said, to fold it and put it back. It's stress. So you have to buy in faith. I now bought. Oga seller, you sold this lot for me. October 2, 2012. Wherever you are, you will not know peace. Long sleeve, oh, I can't forget the color blue. I mean, red and black graph, all those graph shirts, BB graph. I bought it, went home, open cloth. This cloth that this boy that got with punish sold for me. One hand was long sleeve, one hand was sleeveless. I was looking at this cloth. I said, so this other hand is 800. And I told my guy, I said, no, I need a good shop. He said, okay, go to Yabada. I said, how much is jeans? He said, 115. I took 3,000 to buy two jeans. Go to Yabada. The whole shop was blue. I asked the guy, do you have blue jeans? He said, see, it's everywhere. I said, how much? He said, 500. I said, why is it so cheap? He said, just open the bed that I brought from Cotonou. I said, okay, since I brought 3,000, God is working in my favor. Give me six. I bought six jeans, blue jeans. Went home. My roommate was like, you went shopping. I said, it's God. I went to buy two, but God, who saw the heart of his son that was duped last night, decided to favor me with extra four jeans. I brought out six jeans from nylon. This boy again, that my God will also punish, sold six yellow jeans for me. My guy said, you want to join last month? I said, no. He said, why did you not buy yellow jeans? I said, his was blue in the shop. He said, was the guy shop blue? I said, yes. He said, that boy does not have one blue jeans. I entered traffic back to Yaba. God, you are, what nonsense? Why would you sell yellow jeans for me? The guy said, but okay, I don't have yellow jeans. I said, you sold yellow jeans. He said, where is it? Inside the shop. I brought it back. He metamorphosed back to blue. He said, what is it? I said, it's blue. Yeah. Let's go outside. The guy said, I don't sell outside. You know, Lagos, you have to be smart too. You know those staff bus that you see where they write, if my driving is wrong, call this number. Have you ever called that number? I tried that in some weeks, some months ago. School bus, currently two children. The oldest child in that bus should be like 3 years. Java was driving anyhow. So I called the number. Hello, one man picked. He said, how can I help you? I said, well, I'm currently driving behind your school bus, and I want to report your driver because your driver is driving anyhow, endangering the life of children that were brought into your school for you to take care of. What kind of nonsense driver is that? The plate number is BDG278EQ. You need to sanction that driver. And the next thing I heard was, ooh, God will punish you. Oh, you think I'm a fool, eh? Wicked Nigerians. I removed their number and put my personal number. Then went. Oh, you are calling them to sack me. It will not be well with you. Oh, if they sack me now, who will feed my children? Yeah, man. Instead of you to overtake me and tell me, waka, you are calling to sack me. I called the call. I called the second line. Hello. I heard, don't bother the two sima in one foot. Yeah, man. Thank you. So that was the day I realized that everybody in this Lagos is mad. Everybody. Everybody. Even you here. You watching. You are mad, but you don't know. That's why scientifically it's proven that everybody have 2 minutes of madness. But you won't know. Now let me explain how you know you're mad. As a young man, you are talking with your friends, and you say, do you know how much we bought Ronaldo? We. Or you know how much we, they pay Messi. After that argument, you know, I said, can I have 500 to take a care? Oh! You bought Ronaldo 50 million pounds. You don't have transport. You are mad. A lady, how you know that you are mad? By yourself, you go to a hair making saloon and make one hair that covers one part of your eye. You now come out, it's got fringes. You now come out of the saloon and use one hand to remove it so that you can see. Oh, you don't know, say the hair go cover your eye. You are mad. One of my friends used that hair. I was looking at her, I said, I know this other eye. I know this other eye. She now say, it's me, Rita. Oh, oh. I say, what's happening? He said, my brother, I'm envy you. You are doing great. You have a good family. I said, what a man? You are in a relationship? He said, no. I said, what kind of man are you even looking for? He said, I need a man that can run 1,000 miles. I said, my sister, you are in the wrong country. He said, well, some of your husbands are in Kenya. That one was double madness. If you have a child, you have been mad before, but you don't know. Because the things that make children laugh, only God knows. Carry a newborn baby. The baby will smile. You quit. The baby will laugh. Yeah, wah. Now remove the child from the picture. You see, this is the way people are looking at you by yourself. You will say, oh, this fine boy don't crease. Finally, I've only seen one man that is completely mad. Was taken to the psychiatric hospital. He was shouting, I'm okay, release me. All the fellow man, I said, that's what we said when we first came. I've been here 4 years now. He did not tell that to me. Do you know who I am? They said, who are you? He said, I'm a medical doctor. I graduated. For 2 weeks, this man was shouting. The CMD said, it's like, this man is not mad. He said, I know my house. Take me home. They said, are you sure you're okay? He said, I know my house. They were driving. So they decided to take him out to his house. That if he can identify his family members, then he's not mad. It's someone's house at body law. He said, stop. Two boys were coming and I said, those are my sons going to school. They say, are you sure this man is mad? One lady was following them. Said, that is my wife going to work. But should we drop them at school first? Before, this man is not mad. One man was not coming and he said, that is me going to the office. God bless you. Thank you. My name is Forever. Thank you.
All right. Keep it going for Forever. Join us same time for more comedy, the home of original comedy. Ladies and gentlemen, your boy, your man, Basket Mount, a.k.a. the son of pizza, a.k.a. Zegbubu, a.k.a. the green baby hustler, a.k.a. Batman Bob, a.k.a. Bobby Sparkles. See you guys. Stay safe.
Sunday Night Laughs, brought to you by Barron's World and Z Network. Powered by Origin.